playing indoors helps Becker.
That's an interesting one, because the only time they've played has been indoors on a carpet, and they've played three times, and Becker leads 2-1. But if you remember back early in the year, it was the first tournament that Kafelnikov had won. He beat Becker in the finals in Milan. I like Kafelnikov. I think he's a smart young kid. The only problem is he's not a real good fighter, and I feel that if Boris Becker gets on top of him, this young man may go away.
So we will find out who will be in the semi-final here of the Australian. It'll be between Boris Becker and Yevgeny Kafelnikov of Russia in a moment.
The 1996 Ford Australian Open is presented by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
It's the Australian Open Tennis Championships. You're looking at Kafelnikov serving to Becker. First point. They had to clear this stadium of afternoon matches. So as you can see at this stage, the crowd was not in their seats. They were waiting to get in. It is sold out for tonight's match.
And they really moved the crowd in pretty quickly, Cliff. All the players came out in a hurry, started right on 7 o'clock, because there is a long schedule. And if this match goes the distance, as a lot of people think, it's going to be another late one for the spectators. A little bit of a nervous start here from Kafelnikov. It's the first time he's been in this position with Becker. They've played on a few occasions, three occasions, but
15-30.
Starting to rush things in the opening game. Becker's the experience, though. He's been around for quite some time and still has that burning desire to get back to number one. Pretty smart move there from Becker in the opening game.
40. Two break points. I think Becker has just got smarter. Which is, I suppose, usually happens when you get older, Fred. But I mean, he plays smarter tennis now. You know, he used to try to beat guys from the baseline, and that's just not his game. And he's now, I think he uses the court better. He's more aggressive.
Well, when you get to be your age or my age, they don't say it's smarter. They say it's wiser, don't they?
Good two depth. Break points there, save.
Great depth there from Kafelnikov. A couple of miss hits, but just inside the baseline at this stage, he'll take them any way he can get them.
Advantage, Kafelnikov.
Back from 15-40 and then delivers his first ace.
Left court, neither one of them heard it.
No, Becker was ready to walk. He was halfway towards the chair.
Game, Kafelnikov.
First game to Kafelnikov of Russia. He's taking on Becker of Germany at the Australian. To serve to Kafelnikov. Kafelnikov won game to love in the first set. Playing for a place in the semi-finals of the Australian this year. And Becker, boy, ended up the year well at the ATP Tour finals in Frankfurt.
Well, Kafelnikov did a good job to get out of that opening game, because down 15-40, it would not have been good for him to lose that opening service game. A little bit nervous out here against Becker in a quarter-final of a Grand Slam.
Thank you.
got every shot in the book for Kafelnikov. It's just a matter of him keeping his mind on the job for best three out of five sets. That seems to be the problem with him. Becker coming in there, looks as though he's going to win this point, and then zap, with the same motion as he hits the passing shot, he flicks up a topspin lob.
Love 15. He took Kafelnikov out in Frankfurt during the ATP Tour Finals. He also took out Wayne Ferreira. Sampras beat him in the round robin, but then he won it all. Beat Enquist in the semi-final and Michael Chang in the final of the World Championship. Also got to the final of Wimbledon with a big win over Andre Agassi in the semi-final. He was down and looked for all the world like he was down and out of the match, and came back and beat Agassi, and he has a terrible record against Agassi. Like Courier has Agassi's number, Agassi has Becker's number.
Yeah.
He beat him at the Open in the semis, U.S. Open.
Well, we thought that about Courier and Agassi in their quarterfinal match, but a remarkable comeback by Andre Agassi. Two sets to love in a breakdown, 1-11 in the third. Coming back to win his first ever five-setter when he's been down two sets to love. That's the Becker serve, and he follows it up very well with that volley. You can see the snap of the wrist as he punches that one away for the winner.
Kafelnikov had a good Australian last year, got to the quarter final. He took out Todd Martin, who had been a finalist here. But Andre Agassi beat him in the quarters.
Players are superstitious, they all have their superstitions and bits and pieces going on. I would think Kafelnikov, we're playing indoors at night. I think the, you know, the rally hat, the way he's got to turn back the front, must be because he's played some pretty good tennis here this week and doesn't want to change his luck.
Superstitious, huh?
Yep. I think a lot of players get like that during tournaments. They don't shave for the week, or they go to the same restaurant every night, they eat the same food.
Game point, Becker.
Game, Becker.
Becker holds on. It's one game more in the first set. Fred, got an interesting mix of players left in the tournament. You look at, say, Thomas Enquist, for example. Is he... do you put him on a par with Kafelnikov in terms of potential?
Yeah, I do, definitely. He's got to get past Australia's Mark Woodford. But all indications are that he may do that. But Woodford played a tremendous match against Philippoussis. But I think the two coming, and again, Mark Woodford's a veteran. I think the two younger players that are going to threaten Agassi and Sampras and Courier, Becker, those boys, is this young man, Kafelnikov, and Thomas Enquist, along with maybe Renzo Furlan on a clay court, the Italian who did well here.
15-0.
Yeah, I'm not as high on Furlan.
No.
But,
just on a clay. He did a good job here, though. And at the French, he was a quarterfinalist at the French.
And, of course, we don't talk about Thomas Muster in these terms.
Well, Muster, I regard still as a veteran.
Veteran,
also.
Yeah. That is...
Correction.
Called good. And Kafelnikov's not going to like that. It was an overrule, I believe. For the late ball,
15-30.
15-30. 30-0. George Dias of Portugal is in the chair for tonight's match. Becker of, I suppose you could call it old school, really.
in terms of, let's say, he and Woodford are not that far apart in age as you look at him make that volley. And then you've got the group from the U.S. are all about the same age with Michael Chang and Courier, Agassi, Sampras, who's out of the tournament.
Becker wins the game from Kafelnikov and he leads 2-1. He will serve. He has a break. First set, best of 5.
According to most building codes, what kind of support is needed under a load-bearing wall?
It's a huge, huge amount of support. You can't even imagine, because the tonnage that it would take to just would fall through, you'd have to protect yourself.
Sometimes life calls for deeper answers. That's why there's CompuServe. No online service has more informed user groups, more comprehensive databases, and better access to the internet. Enter CompuServe. Call for free software and 10 free hours online.
St. Paul's Cathedral here in Melbourne, which is the capital of the state of Victoria. They call it the Garden State. It has great sports facilities, the best tennis facility in the world. Flinders Park, Becker up 2-1, serving to Kafelnikov.
Now, there's an overrule. That's 2 overrules in the first 3 games of this match from Jorge Diaz. And that return was called long on the return, an immediate overrule. So they will replay the point. Pretty good swinging serve there from Becker. Good 8 feet up that singles line.
He's got Kafelnikov's attention early here in this match with a break. 15 love, 2-1 Becker.
30 love.
That's his second ace.
Yeah, he's pumped up. There's Boris Becker, Mike De Palma. He was his hitting partner there. He's a solid-looking fella sitting next to his Boris Becker's wife, Barbara.
Butch.
Took a little off. Took a lot off that first serve, actually. Tried to spin it in, but missed it. Game point, Becker, second serve.
Becker, you'll find... in the early stages, he has done it. He will continue to do so. We'll get to the Kafelnikov forehand. That's his flashiest shot. But it's also his most inconsistent. He makes more errors on that because it's a very wristy action.
Last year, Becker came into the Australian saying that he thought he could get back to number one in the world. But he went out to Patrick McEnroe in the first round here.
Game, Becker.
Becker holds on and he's got 3-1 first set.
Becker leads by 3-1.
Wednesday, it's a Big East ACC doubleheader as rivals Syracuse and Georgetown tangle at 7 p.m. Eastern. Then the Cavaliers of Virginia visit Lawrence Joel Coliseum at 9 p.m. against Wake Forest's Demon Deacons. College football action tomorrow on ESPN.
15-1.
College basketball, excuse me. Football on the brain with the Super Bowl coming up.
Yeah, Yes, he measured that one very well. He could well have missed it because Becker tried a big 41. Bluff there as he hit that return of serve and came into the net.
Game, Kafelnikov.
So Kafelnikov, who kind of likes to play indoors as well as Becker does, wins the game. He's down 3-2. It's the Ford Australian Open that you're watching. Yevgeny Kafelnikov and Boris Becker. Kafelnikov is down a break of serve. Becker will serve here, leading 3-2 in the first set. It's best of five, of course. There are two semi-finalists in the men's division already. Michael Chang and Andre Agassi, who beat Jim Courier. Kafelnikov beat Courier in Moscow in the Davis Cup finals when the USA played against Russia. And then Kafelnikov lost to Pete Sampras on the final day. U.S. holds the Davis Cup as a result. Stadium is sold out again.
Over the 300,000 mark. Tennis is very healthy down here in Australia. The tournament leading up to the Australian Open in Sydney was 50% up on, or more than that, on attendance last year. Here at the Australian Open, today's attendance put them over the 300 attendance mark, and they've still got five sessions to go. So everybody ecstatic down here.
15-all.
And on top of that, the women's quarterfinal last night had the biggest TV audience ever recorded here in Melbourne watching that match. That match between Chanda Rubin and 15-17 Vicario lasted 3 hours and 33 minutes. Becker has got it all rolling though so far. Both players not doing too well on first serves in the early stages of the match.
15-30 in this game. Tennis Industry Association in the U.S., a group that includes all the manufacturers and the ATP Tour and the USTA, also reporting good things for tennis in the U.S. Becker with a volley that he might have used to die for in the old days. That time stretches forward, puts it away. Very solid volley. Look at it again.
Didn't quite get the angle on the first volley, Becker, so he had to make another stab. Here's the first one there, gets down low, moves in to blanket the court, looking for the one down the line. You could see how he edged over to that forehand side, but right on top of the net, so he was safely able to make the backhand volley.
40-30.
He served very well. That's his fourth ace so far. That one up to 198 kilometers an hour.
Game point, Becker.
That's about 123 miles an hour. Oh.
Second serve.
Another overrule from Jorge Diaz. He pulled it wide. That was a great volley from Becker on that occasion because Kafelnikov was sitting right on it.
Advantage. Very Becker. Mature player, Becker. Look at it again.
There's the volley back there. Kafelnikov, you can see, look, one step and he flashes that one down the line. Becker, good anticipation and firm on the volley.
I mean, he plays with passion, which is why I love to watch Becker play. He's the most passionate tennis player.
Game, Becker.
And he has had an excellent year in 95. He won a couple of tournaments, including the ATP World Championship, taking out Chang in that final. In Milan, Kafelnikov beat him in the final. Monte Carlo on clay, trying to win his first clay court tournament. He lost to Tomas Muster. Wimbledon final, Sampras beat him. He also got to the final of the Paris Indoor. Kafelnikov trying to beat him again here, indoors. Remember, Becker beat him at the ATP Tour Finals in Frankfurt. Wild 15-0. Double fault, and it's 15-all. Becker is just a much more mature player than Kafelnikov. Yep. That's understandable. He's been around a lot longer.
Never ranked number one at the end of the year, though. He was ranked number one January the 28th, 1991, but was never the top-ranked player at the end of any given year, Becker, strangely enough.
Remember when he won it? 15. He did it right here on this court, and then he ran out into the parking lot and went for a jog, basically.
Had to get him back. They had to go and chase him, bring him back for the presentation. Well, Kafelnikov, a very nervous start here for the young man from Sochi. And there's his group, Larissa Nayland, who plays mixed doubles here in women's doubles, and a good friend of Kafelnikov from the same area.
40-30.
It's a resort town on the Black Sea.
Kafelnikov
holds on. It is 4-3. Becker with the break. He'll serve after the later seat. We'll join up for a few minutes. A Ford Australian Open update brought to you by Ford. It was Amanda Kutzer of South Africa in the quarterfinals of the women's singles who took on young Martina Hingis, named after the more famous Martina, but she has made a major splash here at the Sport Australian Open. In the first set, though, the South African got off to a good start and ended up winning it 7-5 after a mini comeback from young Miss Hingis. She won the second set 6-4, but in set three, it was all Amanda Kutzer, who is in the semi-finals of this Australian Open. And Kutzer will take on Anke Huber in the semi-final. Kutzer over Hingis earlier. Boris Becker will serve with the lead. 4-3, break of serve, first set.
Then he opens up the court out for the forehand. That's a typical 15-0. Fast court point from a serve and volley. A break it out wide, open up the court, go into the open court, crowd the net. That lob is not deep enough, so Becker has an easy put away.
Kafelnikov's the number six seed here. Becker's the number four. Kafelnikov has been as high as number four in the world, and he says that in his life, tennis life anyway, things have gone very smoothly. Kafelnikov says that the indoor carpet is his best surface. This is not a carpet, but it is indoors tonight.
Good move again from Becker there, wrong footing his opponent there. He's leaning back, and that allows him to close in, make the backhand volley.
Game point.
Becker leads by 5-3.
One break a serve in the match only, and it went to Becker 3-5.
15 love.
You can watch the You can watch the men's final here on Saturday night at 10 p.m. live from Melbourne. And on Friday night, set your watches for 9:30 p.m. live coverage of the women's singles final. Game point here for Kafelnikov. Kafelnikov holds on, as I said, just one break to serve, but that may be all Boris Becker needs. We'll find out. He'll serve for the first set after a break. It was that year that Becker won this championship and became number one in the world, albeit for only about 12 weeks.
Quiet, please.
I remember when he won the U.S. Open, he had to get by Derek Rostagno in a very tight match. Match point down, as I remember.
15-love.
Hung on to win that, and after that he said, you know, it happens a lot. When you win a major, you've got to get through one very tight match.
I've always believed that. A lot of people don't. I always feel over 2 weeks there's always going to be one match where you really don't play that well. You've got to get it all together
to
try and get through the day. But today, Boris Becker has that rhythm on the serve at this stage. Sometimes he does lose it, but boy, he started off in great fashion with that serve. It's very smooth at the moment. He served six aces.
30 love.
40 love.
Again, with pinpoint accuracy, you always know when Becker's playing well when he consistently breaks that one out wide to the forehand on the deuce court.
Set points to Becker.
Oh. Feel the German fans there with their message. As mentioned, 40-15. It's a very warm time here in Melbourne. The last couple of days, you wouldn't think so, with the rain that we've had, a couple of big storms come through, but the Swedish fans come out here and on junkets, on tours that come out, so do the Germans, and we've had quite a few of the local Italians here this year, so along with the Australians, cheering for Mark Philippoussis, Mark Woodford, and Todd Woodbridge, our top three Australians, done very well this tournament.
Set point still for Becker.
Game two, Becker, one set to none, best of five sets to four.
He will take on, if he wins, the winner of Mark Woodford, the lone Australian left in the tournament. He's got to take on Thomas Enqvist, which is going to be a tough assignment for him. Mike De Palmer, Barbara Becker. First point, second set.
15-love.
Sorry,
Becker has got 44 titles. That's the most of any active player.
40 love.
Why has he enjoyed such longevity?
Becker, I think, just because he loves the game. He was very young, Cliff.
I agree with that, Fred. I think he really loves to play.
Yeah, he does love to play.
He loves to compete.
And he was very young at 17 when he won his first Wimbledon title, and Jan Tyrick had him there and was the mastermind behind the conglomerate, corporate conglomerate that Becker turned into.
Game, Kafelnikov.
He fell sour, but he still loves to play, loves to compete. Kafelnikov leads one game to love, but he lost the first set.
It used to be an old rail yard, this, and they've turned it into something really quite magnificent. Flinders Park and then the Yarra River that meanders slowly by. And a hard serve from the stadium, and you could get it right into the Yarra River. Here's Becker to serve. Second game, second set. He's down 1-0, but he won the first after one break of serve.
Kafelnikov looking for a change of luck. He's changed his shirt after the first set, a very quick first set.
15-love.
Took just a little over half an hour. Well, Kafelnikov needs a little bit of luck at the moment. Hits this one. Becker had it covered. Hit the top of the tape. Watch Becker here. He moves. He's got it covered, but hit the top of the tape, bounced over his racket and inside the line. 15-all.
30-15.
Good, consistent serving from Becker. First serve percentages haven't been very good, but he serves six aces. When he gets the first serve in, he's won most of the points.
Oh. 30 on.
A couple of wild double faults, one committed by Kafelnikov and that one from Becker.
Has not, correct me if I'm wrong, but Fred had a break point against him, Becker.
No.
Game point. Drew's talked about enjoying the game and enjoying competing. Kafelnikov plays as much as anybody on the tour as well. He ended up last year, as you look at this wide volley from Becker, ended up last year in the top 10 in both singles and doubles.
Doesn't have to give the Russian Federation any of his money anymore either. That used to be the case up until about 5 years ago, and the Russians took a stand and said, hey, we're not going to play if we're going to give all this money back to the state.
Chesnikov and Svirova.
They made the first stand, and it certainly has helped the other players from Russia.
A lot of things have changed in Russia.
Yeah, certainly. Still changing. Good deep second serve again. Kafelnikov has yet to establish a break point.
Oh. game, Becker.
Becker holds on, and it's one game all. I would say that Kafelnikov here, when he arrived, said, look, I'm coming out as a contender for the title here. I'm feeling confident. I'm playing well. I like the surface. Beaten just about everybody else in the field. He's a confident young fella.
Love 15.
Plays this one and races for the open court. Becker slides it back in behind his opponent, which is always a great play.
15-0.
You know what I like about Becker, Fred, is this. He gives it 110% all the time. Now, there were times when he used to sort of get a little ornery with himself, but he's matured and he's just in there banging away.
I think he went through that stage, Cliff, where he had a lot of problems with the German press before his marriage and a couple of other problems long before that. He was a young man that couldn't handle it at that stage. As you mentioned, he's matured and he still has that love of the game, wants to compete, now travels around the world with his wife Barbara and their little baby, Noah. And he's got a big following. Look at this here. Boris. Playing him in Germany is like playing against 15,000 people. I think when he plays at Frankfurt in the ATP Tour Finals, it's worth a point a game to him.
40-30.
There you go. They come to Melbourne. Melbourne to Duderstadt. There's so many kilometres we can't see because of the spectators there, but obviously a lot of those folks coming out here on holidays.
It's a hike, I can tell you that. It's a hike to get to Australia from just about anywhere. Unless you're in Indonesia. It's worth the trip, though. Top spin lob attempt is wide. Deuce. Greg Ruzetsky of England now gave Becker a tough time. Five set in the first round.
That 2 sets to 1, didn't he?
Yeah. Advantage won the last 2 sets, 6-3, 6-3. Game point here, Kafelnikov. And then Thomas Johansson also made him play 5. That is why there's been no walk in the park for Becker getting to this stage of the tournament by any means. They're on serve in the second, 2 games to 1, first set to Becker. Ford Australian Open, the draw for this year's championship is still wide open. Woodford has got to take on Enquist. They'll play later tonight. Becker is taking on Kafelnikov now for a place in the semi-finals. Becker over Stephen, but as I said, he had a rough road getting to this quarter-final stage.
And in the bottom half, we do have our 2 semi-finalists, and no surprise, Michael Chang there over Michael Tilstrom. Tilstrom a surprise getting through there as he took out the number 3 player in the world, Thomas Muster. But Jim Courier and Andre Agassi, well, a barn burner. It's been the best of the quarterfinals so far. Went the distance with Courier leading 2 sets to love and a break in the third. Agassi coming back to win his first 5-setter after being down 2 sets to love.
Kafelnikov lead 2 games to 1. In the second set, he lost the first. Pick a winner, Fred.
Oh, Becker.
I mean, not this match.
I thought Kafelnikov might have a run here tonight, but I just don't believe he's a great fighter. And if Becker continues to serve the way he is here, then this is This is going to be a nice win for Becker and an easy one.
Well, I mean, who do you think has the best chance now?
Well, I've gone for Thomas Enqvist. I thought he might be an outside chance, but the way Agassi's timed his run rather well, I think.
I'm going for the least risky pair.
Oh, well, you always do, but somebody's got to stick their neck out and have a decent pick instead of just going for the favourites all the time. There's a little bit of talent from Kafelnikov. Watch the wrist snap. Snaps it up and over the top. No, I'm only having a shot at you there, Cliff. I think Agassi is really...
I would never have guessed, Fred. 15-all.
Really has... I think he was awesome the last two sets today.
Yeah.
He plays like that, but then again, you know, you got another couple of matches.
Yeah, I mean, Michael Chang's going to test him, make no mistake.
30.
Again, out to the forehand, that good solid shot out to the forehand forces Kafelnikov to have a flick at it. And whilst he's going to make some good ones, makes a lot of errors.
Becker had six aces in the first set. Started out firing on all cylinders.
Well, his serve has been very much up and down, hasn't it? It always has been because of that ball toss. If you have a look at the way that left hand goes, it goes nearly behind him and then flicks the ball up. There it is, all the way back, and he flicks it. Sometimes it gets over the top of his head on the too far cross. And he's got to arch his back too far and serves double fault. But when he's in the rhythm, as he is tonight, he's tough to beat. Bit short that one, but Becker just drills that backhand down the line.
Game, Becker.
Becker holds on. It's even, two games all, second set.
Two games all.
Earlier this afternoon, when Jim Courier was taking care of Andre Agassi, it looked as though Thomas Muster might slip in through the back door and become the number one player in the world. But Agassi avoided that by coming back and beating Courier.
Love 15.
Becker again just keeping the pressure on Kafelnikov.
So as things stand now, after this, nice closure there by Becker. Out of reach there of Kafelnikov. As things stand now, Agassi will be number one after the tournament is over. Muster will be number two. Sampras number three. Becker at number four. They are so close, though. I mean, Agassi, Muster, and Sampras are all bunched up there. Becker's a little bit behind.
Love 30 now. Becker with an opportunity. And that last point... That last point was indicative to me the way Becker should play. He was all over the net. Hit one and get into the net. Hit two or get into the net. But not try and rally from the baseline. He gets very stubborn as to how good his backcourt game is. That point, Becker did the right thing. Kafelnikov had to come up with two terrific shots to win it. Here's the first one. He didn't get enough angle on that volley to start off with, and that pushes it up in the air, and then he commits to go down the line. Kafelnikov sees that and doesn't really hit a hard shot cross court. Placement won the day.
Oh, boy, that's super. Super, as they say in Germany, which is where Kafelnikov has a home as well, by the way. Look at this again.
Not a lot of pace on this, allows Becker a full-blooded swing. Look at this, look at the huge backswing, and he just rips that with a big follow-through.
Break point.
Yes,
Deuce.
That's his second serve from Kafelnikov right down the tee.
Advantage.
I bet they're looking for a call there, but they have the Cyclops in operation, which is activated. And Jorge Diaz, the chair umpire, sort of gives the Lions judge a nod, saying, yeah, I'd go with you.
A little trouble in that game, but Kafelnikov holds on serve 3-2. Second set. Becker one set to none. Kafelnikov needs one. '95 was an outstanding year for Boris Becker. Again in November, he captured one of the year's most prized titles by winning the ATP World Championship in Frankfurt. He took out Michael Chang in the deciding match, Thomas Enquist in the semifinals, and among other, and then he beat Wayne Ferreira and Kafelnikov as well. Pete Sampras beat him in the round robin competition, but he stayed alive and won it all. He is trying to beat Kafelnikov here again. He is down 3-2 in the second set, but he's up 1-set to none.
Return a serve that set that one up.
So it looks like he was saying to himself, well, finally I got one by him. Either that or he's there's a maitre d' in there and he wanted a table for one for dinner tonight when this is over.
Oh, that's a great angle. The Kafelnikov can't believe that. He's hit two good returns. Was
15-0.
Sitting in a good position here, topspin lob, and looks as though he's going to get another shot at it, and he just creates the angle there, and this is the time that we all talk about with Kafelnikov, when he's down, when he has the ability to fight back.
You know, we talk about Kafelnikov in glowing terms with regard to his variety of stroke, Fred, and I fully agree with everything you say in that respect. But, you know, Becker, as you see him hit that high backhand, which is one of the toughest shots in tennis, he's a pretty complete player as well.
Well, that was just a pretty easy shot for Kafelnikov, and he's getting very frustrated now because he's not only is he not making the tough ones, he's starting to miss a few easy ones, and frustration is starting to set in a little.
And it gets more frustrating when Becker plays the kind of tennis that he's playing too. Game point.
It shows you the easy stroking of this man, the two-fisted backhand. Now he creates the power of shot. Look at this good shoulder turn, eye on the ball, keeps the head still, and that's those both arms, both fists go out towards the net. Again on a big point, Becker to the forehand side.
Protective gear on those net court judges. Keep them safe.
Game.
He looks like an astronaut or a beekeeper. Australian Open tennis on ESPN2 tomorrow night at 11 p.m. Women's semifinals. It's Monica Seles, Chanda Rubin, Amanda Kutzer, and Anke Huber.
talking about the beekeepers and the net judges there, Cliff. You're not going to see that on the Super 9 or the ATP Tour, because they have an electronic gadget there that is attached to the net that lets you know electronically if the ball has touched the tape. So it's one less job for the umpiring staff. There, where you can see here, they put the fingers on the net, and it's all done with feel. Feel and hearing, and on some occasions they get into trouble for missing. But look at that protective gear.
Yeah, pretty.
I normally wear that playing golf. Great shot.
That was a super shot. I was going to say, Fred, if you keep making some of the remarks that you've been making through this Australian, you might have to wear them up here in the booth, too.
Yeah.
The protection. Look at this.
Out! 30-15.
Well, there was a time when Boris Becker would rant and rave and go back and the veins in the side of his neck would bulge out, something like that. But as you mentioned earlier, he has calmed down somewhat, and rightfully so, let those pass. You've lost the call. It's not going to be an overrule. Don't press it.
30 on.
De Palmer is Becker's coach now. He used to be a part of Nick Bollettieri's team, and then Becker left Bollettieri's and took De Palmer with him.
Out! 40-30.
Well, that just shows you the competitive spirit for Boris Becker, because he knows how much this means. At 30 all, he goes for the big shot, thinks he's made it, and he's missed two returns of serve in this game that barely missed by an inch.
Oh. I'm convinced that the right way for him to play, though, to attack the serve, because he is so tough if he gets to the net. 4-3 on serve. Becker won the first set. You're watching the second set. Australian Open update time, brought to you by Ford. Andre Agassi looked for all the world like he was history from this great championship, the first Grand Slam of the year, losing the first two sets relatively quickly to Jim Courier, where he got an early break in the third set. But Agassi came back and won it in five. So Courier has lost five setters these last 2 years after leading by two sets to none. Last year, Pete Sampras.
Thank you.
So Agassi will take on Chang in the semifinals. Becker to serve, on serve, second set, 3-4.
15-1.
Becker's decided to change his shirt now. Barbara, she looks as though she's reading. Can't be reading a book. She's talking.
Saying a little prayer, maybe.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
He certainly gets into Boris's matches. He's very animated.
Well, Beck is serving so well that he can't afford to go for the big ones. He goes for that big second serve occasionally when he's, well, on most occasions, I shouldn't say just occasionally, on most occasions you'll find Becker lets rip on the second serve.
110 mile an hour on that one, Fred. 30-15.
40-15.
A bit more.
181 Ks, and I've got to look at my sheet here. That's 111 miles an hour.
So it wasn't much harder than his second serve the point before.
No, but it was a good angle.
Yep.
down the middle. That one went 94 k's, which is
120 miles an hour, and Barbara likes that one, no matter what she says.
Four games all, and one set to Becker. Becker winning his first Grand Slam title at Wimbledon. Came the most famous German as a result of that. Of any sport.
Sport, it was pretty much any product, any corporation. I got a great kick out of him when they said he was the second best known name in Germany after Volkswagen. Then Mercedes came up a close third. Trying to put a little delicate half volley there and missed it.
15 all. And that sails long. Well, that was in 1985 that he won his first Wimbledon. He repeated it in 86 and then he won it again. He's been runner up three times at Wimbledon.
Yeah, that center court at Wimbledon he regards pretty much as his living room.
Actually, 95, the last year, when he beat Agassi in the semi-final, made it four times runner-up.
40-15.
He's also won the US Open and this Australian Open, both only once. He's never won the French. Best he's done there is a couple of semi-final showings.
He's never won a clay court event of any type, and that really bugs him when you bring that up. But I can't believe that a player of his stature has not won a clay court event of any description. He got very close at match points in Monte Carlo, but lost to Muster.
It's five games to four. This is the tunes, I'm told, of the busker. Now, you might have to explain what that means for it, whatever it is. It's interesting. Back after this. Kafelnikov changing shirts again. No Russian has won a Grand Slam tournament singles title. Alex Metrovelli reached the Wimbledon final in 1973. Jan Kodesh beat him. That was the year that 80 members of the ATP walked out of Wimbledon.
Kodesh from Czechoslovakia, that was getting pretty close. Yeah, there's that serve again. Kafelnikov looking disgusted. That one's got by him a lot tonight.
Andrei Medvedev, a good friend of Kafelnikov, and I mean, he just had a very mediocre year.
Pretty confident, Becker, when he can come up with shots like that. You know that he's starting to play well. This one short, but a miss hit there from Kafelnikov right in the center of the court. Becker opens his shoulders once more. There's the forehand. Watch what happens here. Short ball, he moves forward. Racket back before the ball bounces.
45.
No trouble on this serve game. As Becker is trying to level the second set at five games all, he's got 40 love. Andre Medvedev made his move in tennis a little sooner than Kafelnikov, who is a late bloomer, relatively speaking. He's 22 years old now. Kafelnikov's actually, he looks much younger than Medvedev, but is just a few months older. They used to play against each other in junior events in the then Soviet Union.
Ball was good. Overrule.
15-1.
Well, I would like to repeat what Andrei Medvedev said then, but might get him a warning.
He didn't.
He didn't, though.
It's wide.
31.
You know, it was called for Kafelnikov, Fred, and you would have thought that if anybody was going to get aggravated, it would have been Becker. 29 winners for Becker today. Kafelnikov's got 23. Actually, it's been a high-quality match. Unforced errors are way below those numbers.
There's a little bit of a miss hit here, but it still pays dividends. Rips this one. I don't think he meant to be as short as that, but it was the way he finished the backhand stroke with that long follow through. He pulled across the ball that made that ball bounce inside the service line.
Oh, you know, 99 times out of 100, Becker from that position is going to win the point. And a big point it was, too. 40-15 now for Kafelnikov.
Game. Kafelnikov.
Six games to five. Becker will serve after a break. It's a spectacular stadium built for tennis. It seats 15,000, 16,000 if you want to put on something like a rock concert here, because you can use the court surface, of course. But it's an important moment here at Flinders Park with Yevgeny Kafelnikov ahead 6-5. Becker has not lost his serve yet in the match, and he's serving here to get into a tiebreaker. Second set, there has only been one break of serve. Becker got it, and he won the first set.
This is crunch time for Kafelnikov because I don't believe he's going to pull a feat. If he loses two sets, he's going to be able to come back from two sets to love down. If he can break even here and get to a set all, then the momentum may switch his way. And he's had the luxury of serving first in this second set, so that means that he stayed one game ahead and he's won the first point. So it's love 15, 6-5 he leads. He can get pretty aggressive in the next two or three points.
Becker's dad's an architect, and he was responsible for building a tennis center very near his home in Germany, Lyman.
Good chance.
Love
now.
30.
Love 30, second serve. Becker's missed on the first serve.
Love 30.
Just when he needed it most.
See how we react to this dangerous situation. Love 30, 5-6, second set.
Solid volley. The difference between first and second serve. When Becker gets his first serve in, he wins 88% of the points in this set. When he missed, it's a two-for-one deal. It's 50%. Even money bet. Look at that. Two first serves and he's back to 30 all.
He is so strong in these situations, but he really is, I think. I mean, he plays them as well as anybody. He's got the serve to back up, you know, the power. Look.
It makes it easy when you get a volley around shoulder height.
Kafelnikov looking for the big one down the middle, and he swings it wide. Clean ace. That is number 13. And a game point for Becker.
Game. Becker.
Make that 14. Kafelnikov in despair. We'll now have to play a tie break to see who wins the second set.
He can't believe this, Kafelnikov. He gets love 30 in this game, and then there's four bullets come at him, four first serves. This is the last one. Gets it down there. He just can't believe it. He says, hey, I've worked so hard. 6-5, love 30. Bang. Ooh. Boy, a little lucky there because Becker nearly tracked it down. That ball hit the tape off the Kafelnikov forehand volley.
Quiet, please.
Just beautiful serving from Becker.
15 aces now. And that's five first serves in a row. That's got to make you wonder. Well, as I said earlier, he goes for him.
That is four double faults for Becker. Oh boy, Kafelnikov in the driver's seat in the tiebreak now. He's got 3-1.
3-1.
Didn't appear to play the shot. Well, it's a big point here, 4-1 now. Look, he didn't even appear to play that.
4-1. Quiet, please.
The man in the hot seat.
Yeah, would like to be in his seat right now. Kafelnikov has 5-1. The players will change ends. Becker will serve one more, then Kafelnikov will serve two. And he should win this tiebreak. Kafelnikov.
Becker's still arguing about this 3 points ago. He's not going to get any joy. It's just going to cost him this set.
You know, Fred, he's 22 years old, but as I said, he's a late bloomer, Kafelnikov. He really only started a full year on the tour in 1990. Diaz has overruled a few, but he didn't overrule that one.
Becker told him that he had stopped playing, that Kafelnikov had stopped playing also. But Kafelnikov really didn't have to stop playing because Becker stopped playing and just pushed it into the net, so Kafelnikov never had to offer another stroke.
So it is Kafelnikov's third full year on the tour only.
Well, this may just be a little too late for Becker after his confrontation with the line judge on the far end there, but he puts away a nice overhead there.
B
Big point second serve.
That is spectacular from Becker.
What great court coverage. He really attacks on the return. Kafelnikov thought he had that one down the line, but a
5-3.
Agility from Becker there. Watch this, how he recovers and gets back on the other side of the court. Doesn't touch the racket with his left hand, just dives for the ball and makes it.
5-3. Boy, he was, I mean, missed his first serve both times.
Couldn't buy a first serve and then a double fault, so Becker's right back in it now.
5-4.
Good serve.
Becker gets out of this one from 5-1 down. This will really mentally get to this young fella.
Straight points for Becker.
Oh, yeah.
Becker.
Well, Becker when he's needed it. And Barbara is saying a prayer for her man there. He's come up with the goods on serve. When he's been down, he's come up with five or three to get out of the game, and then another couple the next game. Five big serve. Down 5-1. Kafelnikov falters, loses two on his serve.
Thank you.
And then Becker answers with two big first serves. Set point.
Becker. He had a very good look at that forehand. Was right in his strike zone, and he just steered it along. Players will change ends at 6 points all. And the Kafelnikov will serve one more, and then Becker two.
That's a good pick on that, because he did steer it, didn't he? He had the short ball, and, rather than just flail away at it the way he normally does on the forehand, he just stayed up on the ball and hit it a good 3 feet long.
Now a set point for Kafelnikov.
7-6, Kafelnikov.
Just as well for Becker, because they can be tough, those misfit shots sometimes.
Yeah, they sort of take a funny bounce. They wrap around the frame and...
and get up.
Yep.
Seven points all.
Eight, seven.
How about that for
a second serve? That's a gutsy second serve, isn't it? You know, out there, you're going over that. You're going over the highest part of the net when you make this one. You've got to stay up a little bit longer on it to get it over the highest part of the net. And he does that deep into the corner. And, boy, that brings up a set point now for Becker.
So.
He wants a net call on that one too, but
fatal.
Fatal.
Yep. It sails wide, and now a set point for Kafelnikov from Becker.
Nine points to eight.
Very anxious on that one, wasn't he? He wanted to get after it and didn't quite get around it far enough. The footwork wasn't there, so he caught it late. Pushed it wide. Well, he's come through again.
That was 116 mile an hour angled serve. He has so much confidence in that game. He's serving a lot better, I think, and that's why in these last couple of years he's been able to make such a solid impression. Here's another look at it.
Well, that's that one, but then that other second serve was 191 kilometers an hour, wasn't it? The second serve out wide, so he's really got the rhythm going. He's thrown in a couple of double faults, four of them, but served 17 aces.
9-9 in the tiebreak. Just great directional play from Becker, and he's got a set point Becker. Now. 18 aces for Becker.
Five, please. Thank you.
Please. That is good. The set goes to Becker on his third set point chance. And Becker leads it by two sets to none. Remember, he was down 5-1 in the tiebreak and came back and won it. Becker is looking good, 2-0 against Kafelnikov of Russia.
My husband and I both work, but when there's a problem with the kids or around the home, I'm usually the one to deal with it. But it's not just me they depend on. It's my income, too. If anything ever happened to me, State Farm can help make sure their future is secure. If you want to talk life insurance with somebody who knows what they're talking about and knows how to listen, talk to a State Farm agent.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Quiet, please.
Flinders Park in Melbourne, Australia is the host site and city of this annual Australian Open Tennis Championship. Quarterfinals, Becker taking on Kafelnikov. Becker leads by 2-0 after winning the second set tiebreak. And Fred, I got to say that even if Enquist beats Woodford, which I expect him to do, I think Becker's going to be in the final here. I really do. I think he's playing that well. I know Enquist's your man.
Well, that's just a, you know, look at Kafelnikov getting frustrated again as Becker continues to dominate with the serve. Boy, it's worked for him. But I think Enquist returns it a little more solidly than Kafelnikov. But, I'll go along with you. If Becker serves like this, there's not much you can do about it. Can't hit what you can't see. And Kafelnikov is really all over the place at the moment.
You know, the biggest story still of this championship was Mark Philippoussis of Australia, because he's Australian. Beating the number one player in the world, Pete Sampras. And he had 29 aces in that match.
Yeah,
Becker's got 21.
Yeah, and everybody said, and including yours truly here, that Philippoussis played nearly a perfect match against Sampras. Sampras didn't play that badly, but it was the serve of Philippoussis, and now it's Boris Becker's serve that is really ripping Kafelnikov apart.
Thank you.
I'll tell you something. The way this point's going, get comfortable, because we could be here a while.
We could be here a while.
Be here a while.
Be here a while.
Hit it in the net.
Young fan, that's the Australian. What is that? Australian hat.
That's the Australian hat.
Love.
Becker leads by 2-0 and 1-0. Now, question is, how much fight does Kafelnikov have in him? Going to take a lot to beat Becker tonight.
Well, this was an interesting confrontation as far as the bookies were concerned. This was, both these players were 4-1 to win the championship. Agassi was the favourite at 2s.
Excuse my naivete, because I'm not a big betting man on
15-30.
I have no control over. Let's watch it again.
Well, Becker's all over the place here. He's got Kafelnikov just not knowing what to do. He's putting the pressure on, keeping it on, and getting to the net. That's where he wins his matches. Net.
But explain this to me. You can go down to this little booth here on the grounds and put real money on these matches.
Yeah. No, they have. It's all legalized here in Australia. They have a...
Can you put as much as you want?
Yeah, there's a betting shop in there. They actually, today, they had the horse races on from various states around Australia. The betting board there.
15-40.
Well, they won't bet in the women's singles because Monica Seles is such a big favourite, but they're taking quite a lot of money as far as the men's are concerned. And they refused to do the double because a lot of folks wanted to bet the double, but they just want to take Seles with somebody else, and it means they're just giving away a better price on the men's, that's all. Men's a bit.
Monica Seles tonight on ESPN2, 11 Eastern Time. 8 o'clock on the Pacific Coast. That'll be a semi-final match. She'll take on Chanda Rubin of the USA. He's had a great event here. But no, as you said, nobody's betting against Seles.
Game, Becker.
Becker gets the break. Early break in the third set. So he's got Becker 2 sets and 2-0. And it looks like Kafelnikov has resigned himself to his fate.
Well, he's worked hard to get here, Cliff, but we said coming in, this man is very fragile mentally. And I've saw him play against Medvedev 3 years ago when, in Monte Carlo. And that was his, as you mentioned, he's only been on the 2 or 3 years. And he's done a great job. But he is a little inexperienced and mentally lets things slip. And it looks as though he hasn't got much fight again today because Becker has been on top. But he's very fragile.
15 long.
But put that name down in your diary because you're going to hear a lot more from this young fella, Yevgeny Kafelnikov. But today's not his day. That's 23 aces for Becker as he creeps up to try and get to 29, which is the record that Philippoussis had the other evening against Pete Sampras.
I think he's going to make it. He's got 24 now. There was another one.
24 coming your way, coming right at you now.
Hey! It worked. I was sure he was going to go down the line. He went cross-court and fooled Becker. Watch this.
Becker just didn't quite get the angle he wanted on this, and Kafelnikov is pretty quick around the court for a tall man. One, two, three, four steps, had the racket ready very early to get it across court.
Five aces for Becker. He makes it look easy when he's serving well. Boy, he's got a terrific rhythm going for him, and I think it's going to carry him through to the final. I think it's Agassi Becker in my book.
So therefore, in your book, it's going to be Agassi as the champion?
Yes.
Game Becker.
Easy game for Becker. He's got three games to love and two sets to none. Pellegrini's Bar downtown here in Melbourne, Australia. They got it all here. The weather, good drinks, whatever it is you want. It's now time for a look back at the Australian Open Championships. Yvonne Lendl taking on, in 1991, a younger-looking Boris Becker. Becker lost the first set, but ended up winning the title here in Australia. That made him number one in the world. You can see his joy here in Australia, and you can see him now leaving the court. He went for a jog outside in the parking lot. He said, thank you very much. I am number one in the world. It didn't last long, but long enough for him to enjoy it. He's enjoying today a lot against Yevgeny Kafelnikov. Becker has got the first two sets and he leads by three games to love.
He believes he can get back to the number one spot. And boy, if he could win the Australian Open, the first Grand Slam of the year, it'd be a good shot of adrenaline for him. Amazing what mentally goes through your mind when a young fellow like Kafelnikov. He had set points, led 5-1 in the second set tiebreaker. Obviously thinking about that, saying, hey, if this was a set all, this would be a different match. But it's a totally different match now because he's heading for the showers.
Out! 30 on.
Kafelnikov has pretty much thrown in the towel. The highlights for me, anyway, of this Australian Open. The Stefan Edberg goodbye to the championship. He lost early. Filipoussis beating Pete Sampras, the top player in the world. Sanchez Vicario and Chanda Rubens. Great match of last night. And then Agassi's very tremendous comeback against Courier today. Becker wins it, and he is in front now by four games to love. You're watching the Australian Open Tennis Championships on ESPN. Hope you're enjoying it. This weekend, you can watch live coverage of the women's singles at 9:30 on Friday, and then the men's singles at 10 p.m. on Saturday. That's Eastern time. Cliff Drysdale alongside the fiery one, Fred Stolle. Hope you're enjoying it. Becker certainly is. He's having an outstanding day. He leads by two sets to none and four games to love. He's taken on Yevgeny Kafelnikov, the 22-year-old Russian. Chang and Agassi are ready, so he's been in the semifinals here. And Becker will take on the winner of the match between Mark Woodford of Australia and Thomas Enqvist, the Swede.
Well, the most interesting thing now, the spectators taking some photographs there, the most interesting now, I mean, Becker's got two service games to see if he can get to 29. That's 29 aces. He has 25. If he gets to 29, that'll be, it'll equal the record of Mark Philippoussis from the other night. He is serving particularly well. Look at this. Again on a string. He's in there and he's sort of in a very innovative volley. This one, you don't see too many of these because he was thinking about letting it bounce and then decided that he'd go forward and just roll the wrist a little bit.
Innovative volley, my friends, what that means. Fred Stolle say, don't try that one at home. The last 49. Nine first serves, not including that one, that Becker has got in have all been aces. It's pretty remarkable.
Oh boy, that's sharp. That is sharp.
28-year-old Boris Becker of Germany is making short work of set three. He leads by 2 sets to none and 5-love now in the third. Back in a minute. It's the Australian Open that you're watching. I'm glad that you joined us today. Becker has enjoyed his day tremendously. He's got Yevgeny Kafelnikov dangling at the end of the string. It's pretty much as good as over. 5 games to love, 2 sets to none, Becker. The second set was interesting. Kafelnikov had 5-1 in the tiebreak. Outside of that, it's been all Becker.
Would have been a different match had this been one set apiece. He had set point. Kafelnikov in the second set. Becker came up with the goods on serve. Kafelnikov faltered when he led 5-1, had a couple of serves, served a double fault.
31.
Dismissed. Game point, Kafelnikov to get on the board here in the third.
Yeah. 40-15.
Becker to serve for the match.
Well, Becker wins this one. He goes on against
Becker leads by 5 games to 1.
Thomas Enqvist, if he beats Mark Woodford, and they've only played once, and that was in the ATP Tour Championships in Frankfurt. That was a semi-final match. Becker won it in 3 sets, 6-4, 6-7, 7-5. So that should be a great one. If he plays Mark Woodford, Becker has beaten Woodford on the 2 occasions that they have met. There's one ace, that puts him up to 26. I think he's just going to get pipped at the post.
Watch us at 11 o'clock tonight on ESPN2, please, and we will bring you some highlights of the final men's quarterfinal match, Woodford-Enqvist. In addition to the women's semifinals.
Out. 15-0.
That's when you think it's over.
15-30.
Look at this return of serve. He wishes he had this earlier.
But remember how Becker responded when he was down love 30, trying to get into the tiebreak in the second set. Four first serves in. He's not going to be denied.
30 on.
Yep. 27. He's got his two aces to finish it off. There's one of them. Well, what a night.
The scoreboard, you know, is showing the aces too.
Five, please. Thank you.
28.
Match point.
That's an overrule. That's way on this far line over there. Kafelnikov very upset with Jorge Diaz. Very rarely will you find the chair umpires, and I think it's I don't like him overruling on that side of the court. It's just so far away. But Jorge Diaz started off the evening. He had three overrules in the first two or three games. And the players lose a lot of confidence in umpires that do that overrule so often.
Second serve, match point.
My hat's off to Becker, Fred. He continually amazes me,
28-year-old, and he has lost none of the fire.
No, he enjoys playing, and Barbara's very happy with that one, as Mike De Palma is, and he's got to be very satisfied with that match this evening. Becker, he came out there, he was in trouble in the second set when things could have turned around. He's a very popular man out here in Australia, and he deserves that victory. 28 aces, he served well when it was needed in the tiebreaker, and that puts him through to semi-finals once more out here in Australia.
Have another look at match point here as Becker goes through over Kafelnikov. He will take on the winner of the Thomas Enquist, the number 7 seed, Swede, who will take on Mark Woodford. Woodford took out Philippoussis, who had beaten Pete Sampras, the number 1 player in the world. Semi-finalist Boris Becker trying to win a second Australian Open.
The 1996 Ford Australian Open is presented by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
As nighttime falls over this spectacular Flinders Park, which is the host stadium for the Australian Open Championship, highlights for the day, Amanda Kutzer of South Africa over Martina Hingis of Switzerland. She won the first set 7-5 after a good start. Then she lost the second, 6-4. But Amanda Kutzer, using her variety and her spin, was able to beat the teen sensation from Switzerland in three sets. 6-1 in the third set. So Kutzer is in the semi-final of the Australian Open. Here now is match point. Amanda Kutzer with a two-handed backhand, winning it in three sets over Hingis. Conchita Martinez had a tough day today. She started out well, winning the first set against Germany's Anke Huber, but Martinez then lost the second two sets. In the third set, she realized that today was not going to be her day, and the German is through to the semifinal as well. Anke Huber of Germany in her second semifinal
of her career. She was hurt during the match, and that was enough for the German, who uses big topspin ground shots off both sides. A little sorry about that, but she wasn't sorry about the win, as this is match point, and Anke Huber of Germany is in her second semi-final Grand Slam. Andre Agassi started out slowly against Jim Courier, who was firing on all cylinders and then some. Courier winning the first two sets relatively easily, but then Agassi came back, won three in a row, and he is in the semi-final. Boris Becker over Kafelnikov tonight in straight sets. He made it look easy after that second set tiebreak win. On ESPN2 tonight at 11 o'clock, women's semifinals. Monica Seles takes on Chanda Rubin, and Anke Huber will take on Amanda Kutzer of South Africa. NCAA Today is next here on ESPN. Been a great day's tennis here for the Fiery One, Fred Stolle. I'm Cliff Drysdale. Thanks a lot for joining us, everybody. See you tonight on ESPN2 at 11 for women's semis. Bye from Melbourne.